Hello students, welcome to the classroom point. Today we shall discuss the answers to the part 2 question paper of the solution topic. I request you to please to subscribe the classroom point. The answer for the first question is formula phi equals to I C R T. The given solutes are glucose and urea. For both of these solutions, I value is equals to 1 because they don't dissociate. So, I value can be neglected and the final formula becomes now phi equals to CRT. Osmotic pressure of the solutions we have to calculate. At a given temperature, for all the solutions, temperature is constant, R value is constant. So, pi is directly proportional to the concentration. Higher the concentration, higher will be the osmotic pressure. But among the given options, option A and B, both are having 1 molar solution. Concentration is same, so osmotic pressure is also same for both of the solutions. In the case of the option C, we have to calculate the final concentration of the mixture of the solution. So, let us try to calculate the final concentration. So, final concentration molarity M3 is equals to M1 V1 plus M2 V2 divided by V1 plus V2. Let us consider the M1 V1 is the molarity and volume of the urea solution and M2 V2 is the molarity and volume of the glucose solution. So, M3 is equals to 1 molar into 100 ml plus 1 molar into 300 ml divided by total volume 100 plus 300 ml. M3 is equals to, this is 100 plus 300 divided by 100 plus 300. Here molarity and ml is the common one. Here directly only milliliter is the common one. That cancel everything. So it goes only one time. M3 is equals to 1 molar. Means all the options A, B, C, solutions are having only 1 molar. So, once molarity is same, then they are all having the same osmotic pressure. Hence, option D is correct. Since they are having same osmotic pressure, they are all isotonic solutions. This is the given data for the second question. In this question, initially we have to discuss the I value. Then we have to go for the degree of dissociation. Alpha values has to be calculated. Formula is delta P by P naught is equals to number of moles of solute divided by number of moles of solute plus number of moles of the solvent. Solute is an ionic compound which dissociates and produces the ions. So, its I value is to be considered. And the number of moles of the solvent. Here solvent is a non-ionic compound, so that I value is equals to 1 and no need to calculate or no need to consider it. Now, let us try to substitute the given data here. Delta P by P naught is equals to 0.50 is equals to number of moles of the solute 2i divided by here also 2i plus number of moles of the solvent is 3 mole. So, now after solving this, we shall get the I value is equals to 1.5. But this is a molecule, ionic molecule which is able to produce the 2 ions. For all ionic substances which dissociates, for them I value can be calculated by using the formula I equals to n minus 1 alpha plus 1. I value is equals to n means number of ions produced by that particular ion after dissociation, that is 2. So, it is 2 minus 1 means 1 alpha. So, alpha plus 1. I value just now here we calculate, that is 1.5 is equals to alpha plus 1, alpha is equals to 0.5 means this particular molecule dissociates only 50%. So out of 2 moles, only 1 mole dissociates, 1 mole do not dissociate. Means if 2 moles dissociates, it is able to produce the 2 Cl minus ions. 50% ionization is there, means only 1 mole dissociates, hence it is able to produce the only 1 Cl minus ion. So 1 Cl minus ion combines with 1 AgNO3 molecule and able to produce only 1 AgCl, which is a white precipitate. Hence among the given options, option A is correct. Answer for the third question is, total pressure is equals to P0A XA plus P0B XB. And this can be written as, in terms of XA we have to write down. Why? Because in the given question also they had asked in terms of XA only. So we can write as a P0A XA plus P0B into 1 minus XA we can write. Why? Because sum of the mole fractions of A and B in a particular solution always equals to 1. So mole fraction of B equals to 1 minus XA. So in the place of XB, I substituted this form. Now it becomes, we can write this form as P0B minus P0B minus P0A into XA. If you multiply and take the XA as the common, this is the total pressure. Now given equation is, (254 - 119 XA). So if we compare this particular form with this one, then in the place of P0B, 254 is there. So P0B is equals to 254 and P0B minus P0A is equals to 119 XA, means 119 is there. So P0B minus P0A is equals to 119 is there. So P0A is equals to 254 minus 119, that equals to 135. Hence option C is correct. In this question, two solutions are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. They are asking about in which side the blue color solution will be formed. Actually, no blue color solution forms. Reason is, semi-permeable membrane allows only solvent molecules to pass through it, but not the solute molecules. Hence, K4FeC and Tkn6. Cannot react with the FeCl3. Once they don't react, then there is no chance for the formation of the blue color. Hence, option D is correct. In this question, we have to discuss the molecular mass of the benzoic acid. From the given formula, delta TF equals to KF into molality. Delta TF equals to KF into molality means weight of solute by molecular weight of solute into 1000 by weight of the solvent. You need to calculate the molecular weight of the solute, that is benzoic acid. Molecular weight of benzoic acid is equals to KF into weight into 1000 divided by delta TF into weight of the solvent. Now let us try to substitute the given data. Among these one, given KF value is 5.2 into weight of the solute 12.2 grams of the benzoic acid. 1000 is the common constant number. Delta TF is equals to 2.6 degree centigrade into weight of the solvent is 100 grams. So by solving all these, we can get the 244. actual molecular mass of benzoic acid is 122 grams per mole. But after calculating, we have got the 244, means two molecules together, they act as a single molecule. So, it forms a dimer. And number of molecules present in the dimer equals to 2. So, hence option B is correct. In this question, let us follow the formula M1V1 is equals to M2V2. Let us consider the M1V1 is for the potassium chloride and M2V2 is for the AgNO3. Try to substitute their respective given values. 25 ml into molarity of the KCl which we need to calculate. And here 20 into 1 m of AgNO3. So, molarity of the KCl is equals to 0.8 and delta Tf equals to I Kf into m. I value is 2 for the potassium chloride because it dissociates and produces 2 ions because it goes 100% dissociation. 2 into 0.8 is the molality into again Kf value also given 2. So, finally delta Tf value is equals to 3.2 degree centigrade. So, hence option B is correct. Answer for this question is formula normality equals to molarity into basicity of the acid. The given acid is H3PO3. So, for H3PO3, phosphorus connects to the hydrogens and oxygens like this. Two hydrogens are connected to the oxygen, one hydrogen is directly connected to the phosphorus, and this hydrogen is a non-removable hydrogen. The hydrogens, those are connected to the oxygen, are removable hydrogen. So, these are the acidic protons. So, this H3PO3 is able to produce only 2 H plus ions and remaining one is HPO3 minus 2. Since it is able to produce only 2 H plus ions, its basicity is equals to 2. So, now normality is equals to given molarity is 0.3 m into 2. So, normality equals to 0.6. Option D is correct. In this question, we have to calculate the volume of the water to be added to a particular solution, 10 NaCl solution, to get the 0.1 HNO3 solution. So, here we have to follow the dilution formula N1V1 is equals to N2V2. This side we shall take the 10 NaCl solution and this side we shall take the 0.1 HNO3 solution, and this is the normality and volume of the 10 NaCl solution. This is the normality and volume of the 0.1 HNO3 solution. Now, let us try to substitute the given data. Here it is 10N into its volume 10 ml is equals to 0.1N into volume of the final solution. So, volume of the final solution is equals to 1000 ml, but we need to calculate the volume of the water to be added, that is V2 minus V1. Final volume is 1000 ml. Initially, this much volume already present, so it has to be subtracted. Then only we will get the water added. 990 ml. Option B is correct. In this question, we have to find out the compounds having a different nature, that is C2H5I plus C2H5OH. One is alcohol, the other one is alkyl iodide. Both are having the different nature, which form here alcohol forms the hydrogen bonding and alkyl iodide cannot form the hydrogen bonding. So, this cannot develop the this cannot form the ideal solution. Hence, option D is correct. The answer for this question is, for all ideal solutions, partial pressure is equals to P0A xA, delta V mixture of the solution is equals to 0, delta H mixture of the solution is also equals to 0. But they are asking which property is not found in ideal solutions. So, they had given like this. So, these are all not the ideal solutions forms. Hence, option D is correct. Hope you understand the solutions of this question paper. If you have any doubt, please do comment in the comment box. Do not forget to subscribe this classroom point. And one more thing, those who do not download the question paper and not having the question paper still now, please go to the description box where you will find the link to download the question paper. Thank you.